In this demonstration, we shall be seeing how we can inject various files into a web server in order to compromise it. So, for this demonstration, I have set up a local server, local web application, where we can test this concept. So, this is the URL for that application. So, just type in the URL and we gain access to the login. The login panel can be bypassed via proper assessment and trying to see our brute forcing and trying to find out the username and password for that. You can set the IDS settings to low so that you can inject the shellcode properly. Otherwise, you will have to use various evasion techniques. So, we shall be looking here for a browse option which is given over here. Here we have to choose an image to upload. So, for this file that we are going to upload, we shall be uploading a shellcode which will give us a backdoor interface to the application. So, opening this in a text editor, we can see that this is the shellcode which I shall be using. And this is base64 encoded so that it can bypass filters properly. Now, what we have to do is we have to rename this to a JPEG file, because for the application to accept this file, it has to be a image format. So we shall be changing it to any name such as latest.php, and looking into the properties of the application, we can see that it is a JPG format image, but basically contains the shellcode which we shall be trying to inject into the application. So clicking on browse, we have to select the image file and click on open. So we have selected the image over here. So before trying to upload, we have to install an add-on called as tamper data. Tamper data is used to intercept requests given by the browser and tamper with it and modify it according to our needs. So just click on upload and we will get this interface. And clicking on tamper, so you will get an interface where it will show various parameters of the requests, such as the header details and what is the data that you are trying to send to the server. So if you just wait for a while, here it is. So looking into the post data, this will give you the kind of data that you are trying to send to the server. So browsing down this content, you'll be able to see that this is the file name of the file which you are trying to inject, and below this will be the actual content of the file. So just have to rename it to a PHP file, as the server executes only files based on the PHP framework. So renaming it and clicking on OK, you can see that we have successfully injected our shell into the application. Now through this, we have created a backdoor access which we can access anytime from a different interface than the application. So we just have to know the URL of that shellcode. So typing in the URL, such as dvwa/hackable/uploads/latest.php, which is the file that you have injected, and it has gone into this directory of the server, we can see that we get an interface for the shellcode. So typing in the default username and password for the shell, which we can change of course via the text editor, and here we can see that we have gotten access to the server, and which includes various details of the server, including the server IP and the disk space utilization and the directories and different features of the shellcode, such as denial of service, different PHP based injection exploits, 404 page malware attack, cPanel tracker and the like. And down here we have different other options, such as we can upload files over here and we can execute any commands, or we can browse through the directories and see what all are the folders and files in the web application. We can deface the application easily using this. So these are various options present in the shellcode. And here, this is the current directory that we have gotten into. So it is important for us to know the security perspective of this as this is the method of injecting shellcode into the application. The process for mitigating such threats would be to install a proper web application firewall or an IDS, such as those inbuilt into the applications like DVWA, which will filter the user input and based on that prevent such attacks. Shellcode is a very powerful tool which is used to hack most of the servers nowadays, and you can actually compromise the whole server from just one website. So this is all for the demonstration. I hope it was informative.